With the extremely low inventory of existing homes right now, you might be feeling a little discouraged about finding the ideal home in your price range. Well, new construction might be a great option for you, but if you're not careful, costs and expectations can sneak up on you and spiral out of control. Today, I'm going to give you four tips in order to avoid costly mistakes when buying new construction. So let's dive in. Hi, I'm Lisa Kelly, Lakeland Homes and Lifestyles, fully licensed realtor with Premier Realty. I'm here every single Monday to help you make smart decisions when buying and selling a house. So please take a second, hit that subscribe button to take advantage of all the great stuff that I have for you on this channel. And be sure to check out all the free bonuses I offer. They're located in the descriptions, especially today's free bonus. Building a new construction home is super exciting, but before you sign any contract, do a little homework first. My first tip to avoid a costly mistake: shop lenders. They're not all alike. Many large builders have their preferred or in-house lenders that may or may not offer competitive rates. If you've been following my channel, you've heard me say this many times: knowledge is power. So shop around first. When in-house and outside lenders compete for your business, you gain leverage to negotiate cost or interest rates. And here's a big one: always look carefully before accepting incentives offered by a builder's lender. They don't always save you money. A builder's lender might say something like, "We'll give you $15,000 of incentives if you go with us." Or the builder might say that they can't offer you the incentives if you don't go with their preferred lender. If an outside lender charges 0.25% in the interest rate over the life of the loan, that $15,000 incentive may wind up being more expensive in the long run. This brings me to tip number two: always have your own representation. And never register or innocently give your name and information to a builder's rep without your realtor. Your personal realtor would be happy to arrange a visit to a model center for you. If you happen to be driving around and want to stop in a model center just to look, the first words you should say when the builder's rep greets you: "We're just here to look. We have a realtor who represents us." You may be asked to fill out a registration card, which is fine. Just make sure that you give your realtor's name, telephone number, and email address. Otherwise, you might find yourself without professional representation in one of the most expensive transactions you'll ever make. I know most of the builders rep here locally, and I can tell you they are all very nice, accommodating, and extremely helpful. But they represent the builder, not you. Unless you do this often, you need a professional to look after your best interest, ask the right questions, and be your advocate. And here's the best part of having your own realtor: you pay nothing. All realtor fees are built into the builder's cost. Tip number three: fully understand the builder's warranties. Did you know that when you buy a new construction home, there's two types of warranties? You'll hear terms like implied and express warranties. It's important to know the difference. Essentially, implied warranties cover defects in workmanship that could impact livability or safety based on local building codes and standards. Implied warranties tend to be vaguely worded, and they usually have a 10-year cutoff period for builders. An express warranty spells out problems and remedies a builder is responsible for, as well as the duration of the warranty and how to go about filing a dispute. Builders live and die on their reputations. The last thing they want to do is get involved in long, drawn-out legal battles. This type of warranty provides more defined terms. Fully understand your builder's warranties. Again, this is another great reason to have your own realtor in your corner. And tip number four: choose your upgrades wisely. One of the most exciting days you'll have when building your new house is the day you go to the design center to pick out all your finishes and upgrades. You'll think you've gone to heaven with all the hundreds of choices you have to touch and to marvel at. I don't want to be a buzzkill, but don't fall into the trap of choosing upgrades that will not increase your home's value. Believe me, they make it so easy to do. But be strong. Don't do it. Here's a couple of tips. Say you want to upgrade, say, from laminate countertops to a level 1 or 2 granite. That's a safe upgrade. Or maybe you want to upgrade carpet to wood or tile. That's also a very safe upgrade. Things like upgrading, say, kitchen cabinets to the high-end level that's going to add another $10,000 is not a good upgrade for right now. You will not get that resale return, or worse, You might be over-improving for the neighborhood, again, not getting the resale return. Now, I'm not saying that these upgrades don't pay off. They do, okay? But there's a time and place, and new construction is not the time. As tempting as it may seem at the time, you'll be so glad you stayed within your budget. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, give me a thumbs up and hit that like button. Also, if you're curious about Polk County Builders and want to know what's being built and where, you're going to want to check out my new construction website. There you'll find all the new construction homes that are available right now, all the lots that are available, and what construction stage that home is in. Most of the information that you find on my site, you won't find it on the MLS or a public website. And yep, it's free, so enjoy. I'm Lisa Kelly, and until then, I'll see you on the next one.